and welcome to Flutiversity. I'm Jenny Tutton, here with another play-along video to go with our practice plan in F major and D minor. Today is day 22, and we are working on musical sequences. So musical sequences is pretty much just another word for a pattern in music. So in the same way as if I said, okay, circle, circle, triangle, circle, circle, triangle, circle, circle, and you obviously know that triangle comes next, we have the same kind of patterns in music. And it's one of the ways that composers can sort of build anticipation and make the audience feel like they're participating in the music. And sometimes that's by continuing the sequence, and sometimes that's by making a little surprise change all of a sudden. But either way, they're wonderful musical elements. The other reason we're practicing them is because they are great for your fingers and they are great for your ears. So if you look at this first line here, notice I've got a pattern that keeps going over and over again, okay? It's almost like a little baby triangle at first. We've got this F to G to F, and then we do it again starting on G, G, A, G, and then next A, B, A, and you can see how it keeps going up the scale and makes a pattern. So this is gonna be great for our technique practice, but also for our musical ear training to figure out what notes are gonna come next. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna play through the whole first two lines of today's practice plan. Make sure you've got your thumb B flat key the whole time. No crazy switching around today. And we're gonna start on our low F. Okay, one and two, ready? That is based, it's based on your scale. We follow the pattern on F and then G, A, da, da. So you can sort of guess what's gonna come next. And in the next section, I made you do just that. So we've got a different pattern. This time, it's three notes that go straight up in a row. F, G, A, and then we do G, A, B flat. And then I've given you the first note of the next group, which is A. And then you have to figure out what two notes come next. So we've got two patterns going on here. We've got our melodic pattern, like the actual pitches of the notes that are going F, G, A, G, A, B, C, B, C, D, okay? And they keep following that pattern. And we've also got a rhythm pattern that keeps repeating where we have eighth, eighth, quarter, eighth, eighth, quarter, or short, short, long, okay? So what I would like for you to do, actually, we're gonna flip things around today. Today, you should pause the video and go through this sequence and see if you can figure it out all by yourself. I've left space in the music there so that you can fill in the different sections if you want to, or better yet, try to work it out in your ears and with your fingers without writing it down. This is gonna help build your musicianship. It's gonna make you a better sight reader. It's gonna mean that someday if you just hear a song and you wanna play it, you might not have to find the sheet music for it, or say you wanna play along with a friend who's making up a song, you can do that too. Okay. So pause the video, figure that out. I will be here to play it with you when you're ready. Are you back yet? Okay. All right, let's play this together. One and two, ready?
Thank you.
Wonderful. How did it go? Hopefully, after you've done it a couple of times, it'll start to feel a little easier, but it's not supposed to be easy the first time. It could be that it's real hard to remember what notes comes next and you're trying to do a bunch of things at the same time. That is totally fine. The more you do it, the better it will get, and it is totally worth the effort. Okay, so next, we are going to do these two sequences again, but in D minor. Notice this one I've split over more than one page just so that you have plenty of space to read it. And if you wanted to write the notes in, you would have the space to do that. So for the first one, we'll do D natural minor. So we're going to keep our key signature the same as F major, the one we're used to the whole time with our thumb B flat key on. Go ahead and pause the video again and see if you can figure this one out on your own, and then we'll come back and do it together. Okay, are you back? We're gonna do this sequence together. Notice it's that same triangle sequence where we go note up, down, note up, down, and we keep following that pattern, okay? So first measure, D-E-D. E, F, E, and then we gave you the start of the next measure. So the next note goes F, G, F, and then G, A, G. So let's see if we can play the whole thing together. We've got this. Ready? Tell you before we go on to the next one is that when we're doing these patterns, there's not always just one answer. You would think that there would be, but when we sort of change things, like when we get to the top and the end of what we're doing, there's a little bit different way. Do you want to pause or do you want to keep right on going? And then the same thing as we're going on the way down. Did you want to play the sequence like exactly like it was? So we would come down and play like if we did our last one was C, D, C, D, then we would do C, D, C, B, C, B. But instead, I flipped it around to make the pattern go down as well. So there are a lot of different ways to do this, and whatever way you picked is wonderful, okay? For our last sequence of the day, we've got those three notes in a row with our short, short, long pattern again. This time, let's branch out and see if we can use our harmonic minor scale. So this time, you're gonna make all of your C's C sharps. So we're raising that seventh note, the leading tone, okay? All of your C's in the whole thing are gonna be C sharps. So go ahead and pause the video for a second and figure that out, and I'll be here when you're ready to play. Okay, so if you're ready to play this sequence, we're gonna start on low D with our pointer finger down. And remember that we are gonna use our harmonic minor scale. So we're gonna use C sharps, still B flats, so thumb B flat key on the whole time, but we are gonna use those C sharps. All right, one and two, ready? Wonderful job, you guys. So, if you have extra time in your practice for today, I would go back and do these again up the octave, okay? It's great practice so that you can work on remembering your high note fingerings, and it's great practice for your ears. Whatever you do, I will see you back tomorrow for day 23. Bye!